Welcome students to PGS Mathematics video classes. I am P. Mallesh, Assistant Professor of Mathematics, BGS College, Mysore. Today I am going to discuss related problems of nth derivative. If y is equal to sine inverse x whole square, show that 1 minus x square y n plus 2 minus of 2 n plus 1 x y n plus 1 minus n squared y n is equal to 0. Given that y is equal to sine inverse x whole square, differentiate this one. Derivative of y with respect to x is y 1. Differentiate this one, 2 sine inverse x whole power 2 minus 1 into derivative of sine inverse x is 1 by root of 1 minus x squared. Here cross multiply this one from RHS to LHS, root of 1 minus x squared y 1, 2 sine inverse x. Squaring this one, 1 minus x squared, here root get cancels, y 1 squared, 2 squared means 4 sine inverse x whole squared, sine inverse x whole squared. Instead of sine inverse x whole squared, I am taking y. Again differentiate with respect to x using product rule. First into derivative second, 2y1 y2 plus second into derivative first 0 minus 2x. 4 into y derivative with respect to x is y1 divided by 2y1. Here if you divide by 2y1, we get 1 minus x squared y2. Here divide by 2y1 means here we get remaining term minus xy1, minus xy1 if we divide by 2y1, here we get 2. Differentiating n times, differentiating n times using Leibniz theorem, we get 1 minus x square, if we differentiate yn, y2, n times we get yn plus 2, n yn plus 1, this one decrease by 1, n yn plus 1, nc 1 means n yn plus 1, 0 minus 2x. Next nc 2, nc 2 means n of n minus 1 by 2, yn plus 1 decreases to yn, differentiate this one, minus 2 into x derivative 1, we get minus 2. Next here differentiate minus xy1, again using Leibniz theorem, x if differentiate y1 means yn plus 1, next nc 1 means n, yn plus 1 decreases to yn, x derivative 1. Next 2 is constant, derivative constant is 0. Next 1 minus x squared yn plus 2, here from these two term, if we take x yn plus 1 common, remaining term 2n, here we get minus 2m minus 1, if we take minus xy1 common we get 2n plus 1. Next if we take minus n common, n squared minus n, here I am taking minus n common, we get n, so nn gets cancels. So n squared, if we take minus n common, we get n squared minus n, I am taking yn common, here if you take minus yn common, remaining term n, so nn gets cancels. So 1 minus x squared yn plus 2 minus of 2n plus 1 x yn plus 1 minus n squared yn is equal to 0. That's all. Given that y is equal to sine inverse x divided by root of 1 minus x squared, I am considering this one, cross multiply. So apply product rule. So using product rule, first function into derivative second, y derivative y1, second into derivative first 1 by 2 root of 1 minus x squared minus 2x, 2 gets cancels, sine inverse x derivative 1 by root of 1 minus x squared. If we take root of 1 minus x squared as a LCM, we get to root of 1 minus x squared whole squared means 1 minus x squared y1 minus xy is equal to 1 by root of 1 minus x squared. These two term gets cancels. So 1 minus x squared y1 minus xy minus 1 is equal to 0. Again differentiate with respect to x, 1 minus x squared y1 derivative y2, y1 into 0 minus 2x. Again apply product rule, x into y derivative y1, y into x derivative 1, 1 derivative 0. 1 minus x squared y2, so minus 2xy1, here minus xy1, add these two, minus 3xy1 minus y is equal to 0. Differentiating n times using Leibniz theorem, we get 1 minus x square, if you differentiate y2 n times yn plus 2, nc1 means n, yn plus 2 reduces to yn plus 1, differentiate this one 0 minus 2x. Next, nc2 means n of n minus 1 by 2, yn plus 1 reduces to yn, minus 2 into 1, minus 2. Next, minus 3, x into, if you differentiate y1 n times yn plus 1. Next, nc1 means n, yn plus 1 reduces to yn, x derivative 1. So, y derivative yn. So, is equal to 0. 1 minus x squared yn plus 2. Next, here from these two terms, we get minus xy1 common 2n, here 3. So, we get 2n plus 3 of x, yn plus 1. I am taking minus xy1 common, remaining term 2n, here 3. Next, I am taking minus yn common, n squared minus n. Next, here, if you take minus yn common, plus 3n. Here, minus yn common, we get 1. So, here 1 minus x square yn plus 2 minus 2n plus 3 x yn plus 1. So, 3n minus n 2n. So, 1 plus x square yn plus 2 minus 2n plus 3 x yn plus 1 minus here n square plus 2n plus 1 can be written as n plus 1 whole square yn. If y is equal to x square minus 1 whole power n, show that x square minus 1 yn plus 2 plus 2x yn plus 1 minus of n plus 1 yn is equal to 0. Given that y is equal to x squared minus 1 whole power n, or differentiate n x squared minus 1 whole power n minus 1 into 2x. Here 2nx, here we know that a power n minus 1 can be written as a power n divided by a. Therefore, x squared minus 1 whole power n minus 1 can be written as x squared minus 1 whole power n divided by x squared minus 1. This one cross multiply from RHS to LHS. X square minus 1 y1 is equal to 2 n xy. Differentiate first into derivative second. Here this one x square minus 1 y1. This one transform RHS to LHS. Minus 2 n x minus 2 n xy is equal to 0. Here again differentiate with respect to x. X square minus 1 y1 derivative y2. Next, y1 into x square derivative 2x. Here, minus 2n, I am taking common using product rule. I am taking x as first function, y as second function. So, first into derivative second, x into y derivative y1, y into x derivative 1. So, x square minus 1, y2. Here, from these two terms, I am taking minus 2xy1 common. So, minus 2 xy1 come. So, 2n xy1 here, it is here 2xy1. If you take common 2 of xy1 common, remaining term is here in this particular case n minus 1. We get like this minus 2n xy1 plus 2xy1. If you take minus 2xy1 common, remaining term n minus 1 minus 2 of n minus 1 xy1. Next, 2ny. Interchange this one. If you write like this, if you take minus 2xy1 common, remaining term, so 2 of n minus 1 xy1. Next, differentiating n times using Leibniz theorem. X squared minus 1, if you differentiate y2 n times, yn plus 2, nc1 means n, yn plus 2 reduces to yn plus 1, 2x. Yeah. Next, nc2, n of n minus 1 by 2. So, yn plus 1 reduces to yn, 2 into x derivative 1. Next, minus 2 of n minus 1, here xy1, apply Leibniz theorem. X into, if you differentiate y1 n times yn plus 1, nc1 means n, next to yn plus 1 reduces to yn, x derivative 1. Next, minus 2n into y, minus 2n, if you differentiate yn times yn. So, x squared minus 1, yn plus 2. Here I am taking xyn plus 1 common. So, remaining term 2n. If you take xyn plus 1 common, remaining term 2n. Here minus 2n. Minus 2n. Minus into minus plus 2 of xyn plus 1. Next, 2n 2n gets cancels. Next, I am taking yn common. N square minus n. Here multiply this minus 2n, 2 of n minus 1 into n. Next, minus 2n of yn. I am taking yn common. So, n squared minus 1 here. 2n of n minus 1. Next, here I am taking minus 2n. There is a term. Next, x squared minus 1 yn plus 2 plus 2x yn plus 1. N squared minus n minus 2n squared plus 2n minus 2n yn is equal to 0. Here 2n to n gets cancels. So here we get x squared minus 1 yn plus 2, 2x yn plus 1, here yn plus 1 plus here minus 2n squared plus n squared means minus n squared. So minus n to x squared minus 1 yn plus 2, 2x yn plus 1. If we take minus n common, so minus n of n plus 1 yn is equal to 0. That's all. If x is equal to log of tan y or y is equal to e power tan inverse x, both are same, show that 1 plus x squared yn plus 2 plus 2 of n plus 1 of x minus 1 yn plus 1 plus n of n plus 1 yn is equal to 0. Here tan of log y is equal to x. Log y is equal to, by definition of inverse function, log y is equal to tan inverse x, because we know that tan inverse x is equal to y. By definition of inverse function, tan x is equal to y means x is equal to tan inverse y. Therefore, log y is equal to tan inverse x. Y is equal to e power tan inverse x. If you take e, y becomes e power tan inverse x. I am changing exponential to log, logarithmic form to exponential form. Log y is equal to tan inverse x means y is equal to e power tan inverse x. I am changing logarithmic form to exponential form. So differentiate e power tan inverse x into, if you differentiate any exponential function, we get same function e power tan inverse x. Next, differentiate power of the function into tan inverse x derivative 1 by 1 plus x square, because here derivative of e power f is nothing but e power f into derivative of f. Next, cross multiply this one. 1 plus x squared y1 is equal to y. Here, using product rule, first into derivative second y2, y1 derivative y2, second into derivative first 0, 2x, y derivative y1. 1 plus x squared y2, this one transfer from 2x y1 minus y1 is equal to 0. If we take y1 as common, so 2x minus 1 of y1 is equal to 0. Differentiate n times, using Leibniz theorem, we get 1 plus x squared. If you differentiate y2 n times, yn plus 2, nc1 means n, yn plus 2 radius as to yn plus 1, 0, 2x. Next, nc2, n of n plus 1 by 2, yn plus 1 radius as to yn, next to 2 into x derivative 1. Next, apply here Leibniz rule in this particular. Here 2x minus 1, if you differentiate y1 n times yn plus 1, nc1 means n, yn plus 1 reduces to yn, 2 into x derivative 1, 2 into 1, 0, so we get 2 itself, this one is equal to 0. 1 plus x, 1 minus x squared yn plus 2, here from these terms I am taking yn plus 1 common. So we get 2nx, here 2nx, 2x minus 1. If you take yn plus 1, yn plus 1 as common. Next, n squared minus n. So we get here 2n of yn is equal to 0. 1 minus x squared yn plus 2. From these two terms, I am taking 2x as common. So we get 2 of n plus 1 of x, I am taking 2x common, here remaining term n, here 1 minus 1 yn plus 1. So here 2n minus n means n. So if you take n squared plus n, if you take n common, n of n plus 1 of yn is equal to 0. That's all. If y is equal to log of x plus root of 1 plus x square, this whole square, show that 1 plus x square yn plus 2 plus 2n plus 1 of x yn plus 1 minus n squared yn is equal to 0. here given that y is equal to log of x plus root of 1 plus x square this whole square. Differentiate 2 of log of x plus root of 1 plus x square whole power 2 minus 1. First differentiate power. Next, we know that log f means 1 by f x plus root of 1 plus x square into differentiate this one. So, x derivative 1, 1, if you differentiate square root of any function, 1 by 2 into root of this one, 0, 2x. So, 2 to gets cancels. So, y1, 2 of log of x plus root of 1 plus x squared, 1 by, I am using this formula, log f means 1 by f into d by ds of f. First differentiate power, log of this function means 1 by f means x plus root of 1 plus x square. Differentiate x derivative 1, if you differentiate square root of any function, 1 by 2 into same function 0 to x. Here x plus root of 1 plus x square, if you take 1 plus x square as LGM, we get like this. Okay, this to term cross multiply 1 plus x square y1 to log of x plus root of 1 plus x square. Squaring 1 plus x square, 1 plus x square y1 square, 4 log x plus root of 1 plus x square, this whole square. So, 1 plus x square y1 square, so 4 y1 from 1. Log of x plus root of 1 plus x square, this whole square is nothing but y. So, instead of this one, I am taking y. Next, again differentiate. Again differentiate with respect to x. We get 1 plus x square, y1 derivative 2y1, y2 plus y1 square into 2x. So, 4y1. First into derivative second, y1 squared is using product rule, first into derivative second 2y1 y2, second into derivative for 0 2x. So, 4 into y1. Next, divide by 2y1. So, 1 plus x square y2 xy1 2. Differentiate n times. Using Leibniz theorem, we get 1 plus x square yn plus 2. If you differentiate y2 n times, yn plus 2, nc1 n, yn plus 2 reduces to yn plus 1, differentiate 2x, nc2 n of n minus 1 by 2, yn plus 1 reduces to yn into 2, 2 into x derivative 1. Next, x into, if you differentiate again using Leibniz theorem, x into, if you differentiate y1 n times yn plus 1, n, nc1 means n, yn into 1 is equal to 0. 1 plus x square, yn plus 2. So, from these two terms, if you take common, x y n plus 1 common, we get 2n here 1. Next, n square minus n plus n y n is equal to 0. Next, 1 plus x square y n plus 2 2n plus 1 x y n plus 1. So, we get n square y n is equal to 0, n squared y n is equal to 0. So this plus, if you take plus, we get n squared y n is equal to 0. That's all. Next I am going to define increasing and decreasing functions. If a function y is equal to f of x, is said to be strictly increasing function of x in the open interval AB of its domain, if condition x1 less than x2 imply f of x1 less than f of x2 for all x1 x2 belongs to AB, if this condition satisfied, we say that strictly increasing means a function y is equal to f of x is said to be strictly increasing function of x in open interval AB of its domain if x1 less than x2 imply f of x1 less than f of x2 for all x1 x2 belongs to open interval AB. Decreasing, a function y is equal to f of x is said to be strictly decreasing function of x in open interval AB of its domain if x1 less than x2 imply f of x1 greater than f of x2 for all x1 x2 belongs to open interval AB. If this condition satisfies, we say that a function is strictly decreasing. Strictly decreasing means a function y is equal to f of x is said to be decreasing function of x in open interval AB if of its domain if x1 less than x2 imply f of x1 greater than f of x2 for all x1 comma x2 belongs to a comma b. Alternative method, we are defining another way also. A function y is equal to f of x is said to be strictly increasing function if f dash of x greater than 0 for all x belongs to a comma b. A function y is equal to f of x is said to be strictly decreasing on AB, open interval AB, if f dash of x less than 0 for all x belongs to a comma b. This one is another form of definition of increasing decreasing functions. That's all. Show that f of x is equal to 3x plus 17 is strictly increasing on R. Second one, show that f of x is equal to e power 2x is strictly increasing on R. Test whether the function f of x is equal to x squared minus 6x plus 3 is increasing on close interval 4 comma R. First question. Given that f of x is equal to 3x plus 17, f dash of x, we get 3. 3 is greater than 0. F dash of x is equal to 3 greater than 0. Therefore, f of x is strictly increasing on R. Because we know that a function f of x is said to be strictly increasing on open interval AB if f dash of x greater than 0 for all x belongs to open interval AB. So here this one is positive, first derivative is positive, therefore f of x is strictly increasing on R. Second one, f of x is equal to e power 2x, differentiate 2e power 2x, this one is greater than 0. If you take any value for x, you can't get 0. So this one is greater than 0, first derivative greater than 0, therefore f of x is strictly increasing on R. Therefore f of x is strictly increasing on R. Third one, f of x is equal to x squared minus 6x plus 3, f dash of x 2x minus 6 in open interval 4, 6, f dash of x in open interval 4, 6 means I have to choose 4, 5, 6 values. If I take 4, I am taking x is equal to 4. 2 into 4 minus 6, we get 8 to positive. If I take 5, so 2 into 5, so we get 4 positive. If I take 6, so 2 into 6, 6, you get 6 greater than 0. In this interval, f dash of x is always, you know, greater than 0. Therefore, f of x is strictly increasing on 4, 6. You can't get negative value in the interval 4, 6. If you take 4, 5, 6, in all cases, we get positive values. If you get positive value for first derivative, then we say that strictly increasing. If we get negative value, we say that strictly decreasing. That's all. First question, let f of x is equal to, find the intervals in which the function are increasing or decreasing. First question, f of x is equal to 2x cube 12x square minus 12x square 18x plus 15. Second one, 2x cube 9x square plus 12x 15. 2x cube 12x square 18x 15. Differentiate with respect to x, we get 6x square 24x 18. 18 into 1, 0. Next, f dash of x. If it takes x common, x square 4x plus 3. So, x square here minus 4x can be written as minus 3x minus x plus 3. If we take x as common, so we get x minus 3, here minus 1 common, we get like this. So 6 of x minus 3, x minus 1. Therefore, f dash of x is equal to 6 of x minus 1, x minus 3. F dash of x is equal to 0. If we take f dash of x is equal to 0, imply x minus 1, x minus 3 is equal to 0. So here we get x minus 1, x minus 3 is equal to 0, 6 1, this one equating to 0. So here this implies x is equal to 1, x is equal to 3. I am taking 1, 3 here, I am taking, if we take like this, the intervals are minus infinity 1, minus infinity 1, minus infinity 1, 1, 3 and 3 comma infinity. We get 3 intervals. In minus infinity comma 1, f dash of x becomes minus infinity comma 1 in between means if it takes 0, this equation we call as number 1, 6 into, if it takes 0 we get minus negative, here also negative, here also negative, we get positive. I am taking value, I am taking only sign. So, f dash of x is equal to 6 into 0 means my negative. Here also we get negative, negative into negative, positive. So, f dash of x, this implies f dash of x greater than 0. Next, in interval 1 comma 3, f dash of x, interval 1 comma 3 means have to take in between 2. If you take 2, 6 into 2, 2 minus 1 positive, 2 minus 1 means positive, 2 minus 3 means negative. So we get negative. This implies f dash of x negative. Next, in interval 3 comma infinity, here if you take here 6 into 2 minus 1 means 1, here 2 minus 3 means 6 into positive into negative, so we get plus into minus minus negative, so f dash of x less than 0. 3 to infinity means if you take 4, 5, 6 like this, 6 into positive, positive, we get positive, therefore f dash of x greater than 0. Therefore, f of x is increasing, f of x is increasing on minus infinity comma 1 union 3 comma infinity, because in both cases we get positive, first derivative is positive, in both cases we get positive, therefore f of x is increasing on minus infinity 1 union 3 comma infinity. Next, f of x is decreasing, decreasing on, so here we get 1 comma 3. In this interval 1 comma 3, f dash of x less than 0, less than 0 means negative, if you get negative the function is decreasing, f of x is decreasing on 1 comma 3, yeah, that's all. Let f of x 2x cube 9x square 12x plus 15, f dash of x 6x square 18x plus 12 into 1 0. So if you take 6 common, x square 3x plus 2, so x square 3x can be written as 2x plus x plus 2. So if you take x plus 2, so 6 of x plus 2, x plus 1, this one is f dash of x. F dash of x is equal to 0 imply 6 of x plus 1, x plus 2 is equal to 0, or x plus 2, x plus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore, x plus 2, x plus 1 is equal to 0. This implies x is equal to minus 2, minus 1. If we take minus 2, minus 1, we get the intervals are minus infinity, minus 2, minus 2, minus 1, minus infinity, minus 2, minus 2, minus 1, and minus 1 comma infinity, minus 1 comma infinity. I am writing in increasing order. In minus infinity f dash of x minus infinity minus 2 means if you take minus 3, negative, minus 3 plus 2 negative, here also minus 3 plus 1 minus negative, so we get positive. This implies f dash of x greater than 0. If you take any value in between minus 3, minus 4, etc. like this. Next, minus 2, minus 1, so f dash of x. Minus 2, minus 1 means if you take minus 1.5, 6 into minus 1.5 plus 2, minus 1.5 plus 1, we get 0.5 minus 0.5, positive, negative. So 6 into positive, negative, we get negative. So f dash of less than 0. Here 2 minus 1.5 means 0.5, minus 1.5 plus 1 means minus 0.5. Here positive, here negative. So plus into minus, minus. Next, in minus 1 comma infinity. So f dash of x. In minus 1 comma infinity means if you take 0, positive, here's a plus 2, plus 1. So 6 into positive we get positive. This implies f dash of x greater than 0. Therefore, f of x is increasing. F of x is increasing on minus infinity, minus 2, because first derivative is positive. Here's a positive union minus 1 comma infinity. Next, f of x is decreasing on minus 2 comma minus 1, because first derivative is negative. Less than 0 means negative. If you get negative, we say that decreasing. If you get positive, we say that increasing. Next, 2x cube minus 15x square plus 36x plus 2. Let f of x, 2x cube, 15x square, 36x plus 2. F dash, 6x square, 30x, 36. If you take 5x plus 6, if you take 6 as common, x squared 5x plus 6, x squared minus 5x can be written as minus 3x minus 2x plus 6. If you take x as common, so here x minus 3 of x minus 2, x minus 2 of x minus 3. So, f dash of x is equal to 0. X minus 2 into x minus 3 is equal to 0. X is equal to 2 comma 3. If you take like this, in between, if you take in between 2 and 3, minus infinity plus infinity, the intervals are minus infinity to 2 to 3 and 3 to infinity. Minus 2 to minus infinity to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to infinity. I am taking in between 2 and 3, minus infinity and plus infinity, we get 3 intervals. In minus infinity comma 2, f dash of x. Here if you take minus infinity to, if you take 0, we get negative 6 minus 2, if you take 0, minus 2 minus 3, negative, negative, so we get positive. Therefore, f dash of x greater than 0. In interval 2 comma 3, 2 comma 3. Here 2 comma 3 means here had to take 2.5. If you take 2.5, 6 into 2.5 minus 2, 2.5 minus 3, we get 0.5 minus 0.5. So 6 into positive, here this one is negative, so we get negative. Therefore, less than 0. In 3 comma infinity. 3 comma infinity means if you take 4, positive, here positive. 6 into positive, positive, so positive. So f dash of x greater than 0. Therefore, f of x is increasing on minus infinity to union 3 comma minus infinity comma 2 union 3 comma infinity. F of x is decreasing on 2 comma 3. F of x is decreasing on 2 comma 3. Thanks for all viewers.